On this episode, I'll be unboxing Time Bandits from Scare Flare Records. Let's cue the music. Hey everybody, and welcome to the show. It's Ralph, and I am opening up my very first Scare Flare Records soundtrack release. A couple months ago, they reached out to me and were going to send me a Texas Chainsaw Massacre soundtrack, I believe, for either a documentary or something else. I wasn't exactly sure, and I've been following Scare Flare for a while. I just haven't picked anything up from them because for any of you that know me and have followed the channel over the last year and a half or so, I'm not a horror guy, so I wasn't too heartbroken that I didn't get sent something. I also talked to the folks at Scare Flare, and they said that they'd want to come on and chat, and 100%, I need to do less unboxings. Or actually, I'm going to be doing less unboxings because I don't have a lot of pre-orders over there, and I need to keep regular episodes on my podcast feed going. So I need to start looking for some regular episodes to do that aren't just unboxings, because the unboxings only show up on YouTube. Cue the Music is also an audio podcast. Actually, it was an audio podcast that started in 2007. Unboxings don't really lend themselves to audio podcasts. I guess I kind of describe everything I'm seeing, but it's more of a visual thing. Anyone from Scare Flare wants to come hang out with me, we could do a StreamYard chat talk about what you guys are up to. I know it's mostly horror. You have the Western record out there, but holy shit, when I saw that they were doing Time Bandits, the score to Time Bandits, I just bought it as fast as I could. I made a note in my calendar when it was releasing, and I bought it as fast as I could because Time Bandits is way up my alley. I think a friend of ours, mutual friend of ours, Scare Flare, is Chris Sapp, who runs Atomic. I'm gonna fuck up the name. Atomic Arts and Posters, Atomic Arts, Chris in Orange County, good friend of mine, used to hang out at the comic shop I used to work at back in 2008. He gets a lot of Scare Flare stuff, so I'm thinking what's going to happen is this. I'm going to open this up, I'm gonna listen to it tonight, I'm going to review it on Instagram tomorrow, and chances are I'm going to like it, because to be honest with you guys, there's not a lot of things I don't like. I'm a fairly positive guy, and if I just fall in love with this, which I think I will, I'll probably just run down to Chris's shop in Santa Ana and pick up Knight Riders, which is something I want. And then in the Western, why can't I think of the restroom? Rio Grande, is it Rio Grande? I think it's Rio Grande. I'll put a nice picture right here. There, that one. So I have a feeling I just need to get into this more. I'm just not a horror guy, and with the Halloween season coming up, I don't think there's a lot for me out there to pre-order. I love things like Waxwork Records, but if you've seen any of my unboxings for Waxwork Records, rarely are they horror movies. And with the name Scare right in the name of the company's title, there's a lot of horror stuff. Let's see how I can open this. It's a nice package, no nonsense. Nice that they put the Fragile on here. Not a lot of people do that, but and some of the mail carriers around here tend not to care. Let's see if I can pull this in. This seems to be on there pretty tight. And let me just tell you, like, I was born in 1977, and I grew up on Time Bandits. I love Time Bandits. Time Bandits is one of those movies where it's like, it it's one of those things where almost every scene visually was like implanted into my skull. It's one of the most visually interesting movies out there. Terry Gilliam is amazing. And it's my favorite Terry Gilliam movie. He's done better movies, but none of them, you know, have the lasting impact that Time Bandits had on me. And the score, which for some reason I always thought was Ray Cooper did the score, but he did, he produced it. But Mike Moran did the score. That's a nice clean mailer you got there. Yeah, and I know that this has the post rec. So here's the deal. I haven't looked up any of this stuff. I went over to Scareflare. They posted a video of their the vinyl, so I know it's like a purple, red, black, white. It's called the most fabulous object in the world, vinyl. And I like that one. And I know over at Terravision they have their own version that you can get an exclusive over there. But I wanted this one because it looked cool. Other than that, all I did is the day it dropped, my alarm went off, I went over, I purchased it, and I bounced. So I don't know what the gatefold looks like, if there even is a gate. I think there's a gatefold, and I don't know what the back looks like. So this is a pretty much a blind buy. Oh, well, here we go. This is first right off the bat. Here's a nice almost like insert for Knight Riders. They're trying to get me to get Knight Riders. Listen, I might go over to Chris's shop in Santa Ana and pick it up, because I haven't seen Knight Riders. But chances are, what I'll do is I'll listen to the score online. I'm sure it's available somewhere, and I might just get it, because what I'm looking at, what you guys aren't seeing, is it looks like Tom Savini as some sort of pharaoh with some lovely people hanging out with him. And of course, you have Ed Harris on this side. So I don't know if this is like an insert that they normally put in the Knight Rider release, but this is quite an advertisement, guys. I might have to get Knight Riders just on the fact that they put this in here. So let's take a look at the cover art. Now, I don't know who did the poster. Oh, hold on, hold on. Let me get the record out, but there's one more thing. There's a card in here. It says Scareflare. Now, if you want to follow Scareflare on Instagram, just go ahead and scan that code, and it'll take you right to them. So there you go. Go follow Scareflare, because they're putting out cool stuff. And they're fairly new. And the stuff they're putting out is real quality. Like, as far as like, I mean, I haven't seen the record yet, but as far as the movies they're getting to release, they're kind of cool. It's just, I'm not a horror guy, so the next time they put out something like Time Bandits, I'm all over it. So we're gonna get a lot of glare here on this record, and I'll take that off soon. Let's take a look at the hype sticker. There, let's get in there. There you go. Time Bandits. Let's see what it says. First time available on vinyl, remastered from the original master tapes. Awesome. Liner notes by Mike Moran, who's the composer. Artwork by Terry Gilliam. So Terry Gilliam, I was wondering about this. If Terry Gilliam did the poster for Time Bandits, and it appears to be so. And then it also says artwork by Brad Mrock. And I'm assuming, because you got the map on the back, I'm assuming the gatefold art would be Brad Mrock, M-R-O-C-K. This is a 140 gram vinyl, and this is there's an insert in here. So let's get to look at that. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna go through this stuff with you one at a time, and then I'll have a review for you guys on my YouTube community tab. Also over at cuethemusicpodcast.com, and then also at instagram.com/cuethemusicpodcast. And I can't wait to listen to this, because this is one of those things. I'm not usually a guy who's into scores that are samples, synths, unless they're used as samples and synths, if you know what I mean. Let me see if I can explain this. I'm gonna show you. I should have done this before, but if you want to make sure you get that, if you don't have it, scan that code in your Discogs, put it in your want list, or if you have it like me, use that code to put it in your collection. So the thing is, I completely lost my train of thought. What was I going to talk about? I don't remember. It had to do with time bandits. Oh, synths. So I love Les Matos. Les Matos, who did Turbo Kid, Summer of '84, Exode, Ninja Dominator trilogy. They've done a bunch. They also provided the music for Cue the Music. So the music you hear at the beginning and at the end are from Les Matos. They put out some great stuff through Death Waltz Records. Check them out. I love them. They're electronic based. They're kind of, I guess you would call them synth wave. And I like that. I like when electronics are used as electronics. They're not used to mimic sort of real life instruments. So movies like Princess Bride, I think, I believe it was Mark Knopfler did that. Am I mistaken? It is Mark Knopfler, right? That doesn't sound right, but I think it's Mark Knopfler for Princess Bride. Mention it in the comments. Normally, I would just put up a thing here correcting myself, but yeah, just mention it in the comments. I could use more comments on my videos. Used electronics to mimic an orchestra, and that's something I'm not into. And Michael Moran's score to this, although it has some live percussion, Ray Cooper, I believe, produced it. I remember hearing about Ray Cooper running around during the scoring session and hitting all kinds of percussions around the room. Terry Gilliam mentioned that in his commentary on the Criterion release of Time Bandits. But normally I don't go for that kind of thing, the electronics in place of traditional instruments and traditional orchestra. Time Bandits is that. Time Bandits has a lot of synths, samples. Also, I don't, again, I've been listening to scores since 1981, since I was like 4 years old, and never bothered to learn. Learn. I just love it. I just love film score, and I don't really want to know how the sausage is made. But what I'm trying to say is this music is electronic. It's partially electronic, not orchestral, and I'm fine with it for some reason. Unlike Princess Bride. Princess Bride, I'd love Princess Bride to have them do an orchestrated version of the score, because I like the score. I just wish it was real instruments. So let's take a look in here, see if I can't get that 12 by 12 insert. Here it is. And oh, we have the Supreme Being. Sorry. And there's some words on here. And it is the oh, this is the liner notes. This is all everything you need to know about this release and who put it together is right on here. And my apologies for the glare, but I will have detailed images of this on my socials. And here's your Mike Moran liner notes. You can either pause and read it now, or check out the detailed pictures at instagram.com/cuethemusicpodcast. So let's take a look at this. This is a nice, it's not quite super glossy, but it's not quite matte. I really like this finish because it's not gonna leave my grubby fingerprints all over it. The packaging with the shipping got a little bit of a slight ding right here. I don't even know if you're gonna be able to pick that up, but it's right here. But guess what? I don't care because this is great. It's a classic poster. I love the artwork. Let's take a look at the back. And this is your track list, nice and big. You guys are going to be able to read that here. So there's your track list. Supreme Being Music. And I believe this is also produced by the movie was produced by George Harrison. And it doesn't look like the George Harrison song is on here. At least it's not advertised that it's on here, which I guess makes sense. This is just the score album, which I'm totally fine with. But if you ever get a chance to listen to the song from Time Bandits, it's great because it's essentially George Harrison, who's the producer of the film, kind of throwing shade at Terry Gilliam probably for production woes, because Terry Gilliam is sort of notorious for production woes. Okay, so we're gonna look at the Gatefold. I haven't seen the Gatefold yet, and it's probably that other artist that was mentioned here. Okay, look at that. I need to get that all the way in the shot. And there we are. Evil, played by David Warner. You got the giant Legos. And you have, was it Og that got turned into the pig? Yeah. And then you have these demons with the heads. This is really cool. I like this. This is a good gatefold. This is really good. Evil, one of the best designed characters ever in movies. I mean, just for that alone is worth the price of admission. Okay. Finally, we're going to look at the vinyl. And this is the most fabulous object in the world, vinyl. Again, a reference. It's original motion picture score by Mike Moran. And I'm going to bring this out and we'll look at side one. Oh, wow, this is real pretty. This is real pretty. Look at this colors. Wow. So this is your side A. I'm so sorry about all the glare. I'll angle it, I guess. I mean, I'm just getting everything on here. But yeah, it's like a deep purple burgundy with blue with sort of a black and white spray effect. That's really great. And you have the Time Bandits logo, a logo that I absolutely adore because I took one semester of typography in college. And so seeing all the little, how the word or the letters, each letter in Time Bandits is sort of drafted out with like a compass and rulers and protractors and stuff. I've always had a soft spot for the logo. So that's side one. We're calling this side one. And you can just see everything in here. Side two has a bit of the map. And it looks like it's the center of the map in which the Time Bandits use to travel through time and space and go do robberies. They go do robberies. This is a really, really pretty vinyl. I don't know what else to say. Like, look at that. It's terrific. And it has nice sort of color scheme that fits with the record itself. So I absolutely love this vinyl. I'm gonna go listen to this, and as soon as I'm done, I'm gonna draft a review for the page, and let Scareflare know that most likely I love it to death. Because that's usually how my reviews go. But what I'm going to do is, while I'm writing that review, I'm going to go listen to Knight Riders. And if I'm liking it, I'm going to run over to Atomic. Oh my God, I keep forgetting. Atomic Toys, Atomic Art, Atomic Toys and Poster. I'll just put it right here. Chris. Everyone visit Chris. And I might go down and grab Knight Riders because this is a great release so far. I can't wait to listen to it. The gatefold, the spine is like, let me see if I can get you, is perfectly folded. That's a thing. I've worked at a record plant for a very, very short amount of time, and I was working on the gatefold machine, and getting stuff this crisp and this tight is not easy to do. And so the quality control over there is great. This is Scareflare Records release number 10. So they're relatively new. And I'll be buying a lot more of their stuff as long as it's, not a movie that scares the pants off of me. So we'll see how that goes. Thank you guys so much. Anytime you want to come on the show and promote anything, let me know. I'll be more than happy to welcome you guys on the program. And thank you so much for putting out Time Bandits. It's a score I didn't even think about that I wanted until you posted the images of this. And I'm glad it came out so quick. I'm glad it was ready to go, because I don't know if I would have had to pre-order this and then wait like months and months and months I would have been in agony. But I'm glad that this was a nice quick turnaround. Thank you guys at Scareflare. Thanks everybody for watching me. Look for my review on this album soon. You can see that right below here in the comments section on YouTube or on Instagram, Twitter. I'll post links. You'll find me. You guys know where to find me, right? Right. All right, guys. Thanks so much. I'll catch you on the flip side. Bye.